Thank you for tuning in. You're now tuned into Difficult People Chronicles, Seriously Focused Johnnie, SF Johnnie. Today is a Q&A, being spiritual. Seriously Focused Johnnie, what problem do you face as a spiritual person? I'm spiritual. I'm curious to know if we think alike. So some of the problems that I face being spiritual, like I said in one of my other podcasts, and when I realized just how spiritual I was, I didn't want it. I was like, I don't want no part of it. I don't want to know people's business. Like, at the time, I was broken in a sense where I needed to heal because I had been through something. But God was still talking to me, giving me direction. And I would sit quietly and then I could see certain situations playing out in other people's lives. And I'm just like, oh my goodness, this person don't even see their enemy coming. This person don't even see the enemies around them. This person, oh my goodness. And it got to the point where God started talking to me more and more and more. And I was getting stressed out. I was getting stressed out. I mean, it was a good thing and all, but it was never about me. It was about other people. It was just like, you know, you want me to go over to this person and say what now? That person don't even like me. You know? I had to take my ego out of a lot of situations. Now I don't really care. Like, God talks to me, and if he says you need to tell that person X, Y, Z, I'm going to tell them. If they like me before or after, so be it. Mm-hmm. But back then, I was like, I don't want to do it. God said, go here, do this, take a drive here. You're going to meet this person, do this, do that. I was like, no, I don't really want to. But then I found that when I started dragging my feet, I started running into a whole heap of problems. So I start to move differently now. Some of the problems I face, number one, remembering what God told me. For example, he came to me one time and said, I will fight your battles. And sometimes, well, that particular time, actually, my ego was in the mix. And it was just like, I wanted to call one of my friends at the time and say, look, pray for me. I'm about to do something. I'm about to find that person's address or call them on the phone or just, yeah. And then somebody said to me, you said some time ago, God said he'll fight your battles. I said, yeah, but when it comes to spiritual warfare, things like this is not easy. Because this person is crazy. Like, a person who's demonic will... demonic and a witch, okay? Demonic witch will do so much that you start to lose it. Because you want to put your hands on them, but you can't. And I had to remember that that one time I go outside of the will of God. Like, if God tells me don't do something and I go do it on my own recognizance, I'm going to end up in trouble. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. That's one of the things I have to think about. That God will fight my battles. I have to remember that. Number two, I have to remember that the fight, my fight, is with the spirit and not with the flesh. You know how many times I argue with people round and round in circles, or even go, I used to go to one of my friends and I used to be like, I used to tell her the situation, the argument that I'm in and the argument I had with someone and how I told the person over and over again and they just don't get it or give someone direction. And then my friend would say, well, explain it to them one more time. And it's like, you start yelling at the top of your lungs. It's like, look, I explained it to this person 80 million times. So you're trying to tell me that I should do it 100 million times? I don't have the energy for that kind of nonsense. And she would just be like, oh, one more time, you know, and maybe you should explain it like this. And it was just like, yo, you explain it back and forth, up and down, north, east, and west, draw a picture, get marbles, get glue sticks, add grapes, draw triangles, circles, dotted lines, and they still don't get it. And then you get a friend that says, explain it to them one more time. And you start arguing. And you argue. And you argue. I had to remember, my fight is with spirit and not with flesh. And a lot of people is not operating in the right spirit. I have to remember that. Number three, I got to remember that when the world says trust whomever, like a person might say, trust me, not me, but the other person, like they might say to me, you know, Johnnie, trust me. I have to go to God in everything, because I might want to trust someone who is spiritually weak and in the world, if that makes sense. They are basically spiritually weak and followers. Or it could be a situation where the person is bewitched. And at that time, they're not even in the right spirit. And they come to you and they say some things and you follow that direction off of trust. And that trust leads you down a dark alley, in the dungeon, in the gutter, or dead. So I have to remember to go to God in everything. So even if a person say, trust me, I just put it in the back of my head and I'll go straight to God. Number four, remembering whatever I do for God is a learning process that never stops. So, for example, he might give me the word about something today, and that one word, lesson, lecture, vision, whatever it is, can go on for months, where I have to research, where I have to do some things. It's a learning process that never stops. Number five, I gotta remember to ask God if I should pray for a person. There was a quote that somebody said that said that it's not the person that don't like you, it might be them demons in them that don't like you. I don't remember who said that, but what I know is, and this is facts, hopefully soon I'll be able to tell y'all my story when God gives me to go. I'm dying to tell y'all. Y'all just don't even know. But I know that part of it is when I was going through a crazy time. And this was in the beginning where I was in the spiritual warfare, where I was being attacked like every other day. Every other day. And my gut feeling was like, I feel like this person is my enemy. But I'm not going to lie. I didn't go to God in prayer. Then when God came to me and told me some things, the first thing I did, I'm not going to lie, is I cried, because I was just like, I would never do that to anybody. Like, I'm not that cold-hearted person. You know, I'm not. At all. You know, a person will have to get me to that place. Meaning, like, you know, everybody has their breaking point. Like, you mess with their mother, you mess with their kids, it's a done deal. And when I saw this person was just coming for me just because... When a person has a Jezebel spirit, it's all about control. Control. It's like, I'ma control you no matter what. Even if I gotta kill you to control you. And during that time, God said, revenge is mine, I will repay. And I was just like, yo, please. Just one time. Just give me a pass. And I just couldn't. Because then the people around me kept reminding me about certain things. And I went, got down on my knees. And I remember that night, you know, tears came to my eyes. And I prayed for that person. And I asked God to give that person a loving heart, that they will stop what they're doing. Because what they're doing is, like, they're a murderer, basically. You know, there's no way around it. They're a murderer. And then I said, you know, I asked God to give this female a loving heart, that she could stop with this whole witchery business. And that night I went to bed. That was a fight of my life. When I tell you it was a fight of my life, people in my family, because they were like, well, what did you pray about? It was a fight of my life. Mm-hmm. And that was the second time that I had a situation like that. So I understood the second time around what was going on. What was happening was that I prayed that she have a loving heart, but she got so many demons in her that them demons is legions. So she's like high rank demon. And them demons ain't trying to hear about change. They not trying to hear about no love. They not trying to hear about God. They will kill you because you talking about things they don't like. Well, praying about things they don't like. And that's what the attack was about. The first time that I encountered something like that, it wasn't, no, yeah, whoo, yeah, it was, yes, I remember. Jesus. The first time around, a guy, he's single, and this person who's his enemy, I can't even say she's an enemy, I can say that she is a witch. And she has a Jezebel spirit. So she was trying to, at that time, I don't know what it's like now because I don't socialize with him like that, but she was trying to bewitch him. And she was trying to control him and she was trying to just use him and all this other stuff. So in the interim of things, she saw me. Okay. So when I saw her, now understand when I say I saw her, God gave me a picture of what she looks like. So I saw her. She went in the spiritual realm as a witch and she saw me. And she saw me. And then let's say it was another person who was with her and they saw me. It was a fight of my life. And understand, it was a fight of my life because she was trying to steal my identity. So every time I went to sleep, it was a fight. Yep. She was trying to steal my identity. She saw me as beautiful, and then she was trying to attack my beauty. Okay, how can I say this? If a demonic person knows that a person that they want to go after has someone around them that has the potential to pray for them, and they're trying to attack that person, they're going to try to destroy you. So if you are the chosen and you're around someone that this demonic spirit is trying to harm, they're going to try to attack you first. So you cannot pray for them. That was the first time I witnessed whatever. Sometimes, and the fight when it came to him, it was because, you know, at the time I expressed my concerns to him. And then when I saw his enemies, I prayed, you know, like X, Y, and Z. Yeah, they didn't like that at all. So that's why I say I have to remember to ask God if I should pray for the person. And along with that, what should I pray about? Because when you're dealing with the demons and the enemies and the Jezebel spirits and the wizards and the warlocks and the high priests and the demonic entities, the rulers of darkness and the minions and the gremlins, you gotta hit the prayers on point. Because when they come to attack, yeah. And it's like you have to have your armor. I'll go more into that when I get the go. Number 6. I have to remember that I don't have to be beautiful according to the world. What matters is that I feel beautiful and how God sees me. Because this world is moving, I don't know, you know, everything to them is like, whew, Jesus. They're like, you got to have makeup, you got to have wigs, you got to have a whole heap of this and a whole heap of that, you got to do this, you got to do, and sometimes it depends where you live. You go to a particular state, you got to have all that. Like, you got to be done up as soon, just to go to the supermarket, because that's the environment that's over there. I have to remember and not get so caught up in the world. Number 7, I have to remember to say no when my time with God is interrupted. Meaning that you have some people that are narcissists. And what happens is, person who sat a particular time, let's just say to spend with God, or, you know, certain times throughout the day. And there's this one person whose spirit is not right. so they can feel when you're connecting with God, and they'll deliberately try to interrupt you. And I had that happen where this one guy, every time I'm connected, he's always calling me. That particular time, no other time but that time. And then you don't answer the phone, he's like back to back to back calling until you answer. No, you gotta learn to say no. Your time with God is more important, and I have to remember that. And cut the phone off. I have to remember that. Even if people want me to go somewhere with them, and, you know, I have a particular day that I'm doing something very important, and they can't seem to understand, no. And I have to be strong with my no, stand on my word, and keep it moving. And if they feel some kind of way, so be it. So those are just some of the things that I deal with. There's other problems I have. I don't even remember when it comes to my spirituality for right now. But those are the seven things. Yeah. Number one, remembering what God told me. He'll fight my battles. Number two, remembering that I'm fighting with the spirit and not with the flesh. Remembering the world says trust. I have to go to God in everything because can't trust people. Number four, remembering whatever I do for God is a learning process and never stops. Number five, remembering to ask God if I should pray for the person because you don't know what kind of demons you're going to be dealing with that person. And then another thing is you don't know if a person comes up to you and says, pray for me. This is a sidebar. You gotta ask them, what did they do? They're not gonna always tell you the truth. And some things they're going through is karma. Some things they're going through is punishment from God. And God is the parent. So you don't wanna intervene when they getting their behind whooped. Number six, you just gotta remember that you're beautiful regardless and just work on yourself. You know, the world may say otherwise, but forget it. Forget about what they say, because some of them going to hell in a handbasket with fleece socks. Number seven, knowing that your time with God is a priority. Yeah, so that's it for today. I hope this helps. For one-on-one sessions, hit me up. For suggested topics, put in the subject box topic and email me. Check out my store. Check me out on YouTube. Like, subscribe, and click the notification. Check out my store. All the links is underneath. Love me more, and I love you more. Have a blessed week. Later.